Follow me.
That means I want to go and bury my father.
There are always scenarios that will come that will really test which one is a priority in your life. Which thing do you prioritize?
You will always be tested on that one.
What do you prioritize? This and that.
Many of us are still bound by familiar spirits. We're still bound by familiar spirits. That's why we cannot rise above. That's why we are failing. For you to be a family deliverer, you must first of all conquer the familiar spirit that captains that family. Then you can deliver them. How can you pull a man out of a pit when you are still in the pit? You have to come out of the pit and then, hey guys, let me take you out of the what? Of the pit. If you are still under the same bondage with them, if you have not yet defeated what is tormenting them, you can never save them. You know, when you look at those things, there's a reason. Why did God have to take Moses out of Egypt for some days and took him to the wilderness, to the Midianites, to Jethro the Midianite? And he was in the wilderness for many years. He grew in Pharaoh's house. Remember, he was a prince in Pharaoh's house. But God caused things to happen in Moses' life. He made blunders. Those blunders were not of his making. God was behind it. He caused Moses to make blunders. The blunder that would not allow him to stay in the same place. These blunders had to chuck him out of the land of Egypt, the comfort, a place of comfort where he was a prince. Imagine you are a prince, all of a sudden you're in the wilderness, you are heading ship, you are a servant. God wanted to remove Egypt from Moses. First, he had to remove Egypt out of his heart. And then when Egypt was taken out of him, then God says, now, because Egypt is out of you, you can now go and bring them out of Egypt. Amen. There was no way Moses could remove them out of Egypt when he's full of Egypt. That's why Moses was not struggling now, because he was no longer struggling with Egyptian powers. See, God had to clean him in the wilderness. You know, a wilderness is a place of fasting. It's a place of dryness. It was like a fast. He was fasting. He was actually in a fast because he was no longer enjoying the delicacies. He was no longer eating the king's food. He was eating fruits, dried fruits, and water in the wilderness, the sun. That was fasting. And the fasting was meant to take Egypt out of him. I don't know if I'm talking to you.
Amen.
So if you want to deliver people, first of all, get that thing out of you. First of all, overcome. Overcome, overcome, overcome. If you want to see God blessing people, put to practice the principles and you'll see that anointing will move without any struggle. Amen.
Amen.
For me, I don't want to teach. You see, we teach giving. Yeah, we are leaders, we teach giving. All my leaders, they're mix it with faith. Mix it with faith. Hallelujah. Mix the word with faith. When the word comes, mix it with faith. Amen.
Amen.
That's how you can see the power of the word. You will know the power of the word when you mix it with what? With faith. You know, Peter mixed the word with what? With faith. We tend to believe our circumstances more than the word of God. Are you hearing me? The Bible says, Jesus said to him, cast unto the deep for a catch. Cast unto the deep for a draw. That's the other version. The other one says, launch unto the deep for a what? For a catch. Peter struggled a bit because of his circumstance. He said, Lord, we toiled all night and we have not caught anything. He was a professional fisherman. He said, we toiled the whole night, but we caught nothing. But there is one switch in Peter's life. He said, nevertheless, at thy word, I will launch the net. Nevertheless, at thy what? At thy word. In other words, Peter says, I'm struggling. You know, God does not mind our struggle with doubt. But struggle with doubt as you do. Never allow doubt to stop you. Do you know that the Bible says Peter followed him? When Peter was locked in the prison, the Bible says the angel said, "Follow me." Took Peter from the gates that were locked. The Bible says Peter followed the angel, doubting. Are you hearing me? Doubting that whether these things were so, but he kept on following. Even if you are doubting, go follow. Are you hearing me? If you are not sure, just do it. You are doubting. Even great men of God, bigger men of God, that were struggling with doubt. Even Moses. Do you think that he was overconfident when he was by the sea? No. He was sweating. There was doubt. But he just said, I doubt. There is doubt. But I will do it. I will obey God. Even if you are struggling with doubt, do it. Peter said, nevertheless, at thy word, I am bold to cast the net. And the Bible says he was shocked by the outcome. The net was breaking. The net was breaking. The net was what?
Breaking.
Was breaking. And you know, sometimes the more testimonies that you see in your life, the stronger your faith grows. David's assurance. How did David know that he can keep Goliath? Because of those testimonies. Two testimonies were enough. How many testimonies have we seen? But we keep doubting. It's like we pass grade one, we go back to it, we pass grade one, we go back to it, we pass, we fail, we pass. God has done something. Now you have seen that God has never let you down. But still, when a circumstance, a situation comes, you still doubt. You have to graduate. You have to graduate. There are certain things you just need to say, this one, I'm above this level.
Amen.
You just have to say, I'm above this level. Amen.
Amen.
There are levels that you must not want to struggle with now. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So Peter was still doubting, but he obeyed God. Mix the word with faith. Mix the word with faith. I can show you people who mixed the word of God with faith, and the result was so mind-blowing. Remember this, the Jairus, not Jairus, the centurion. The centurion, he sent people and told Jesus, look, my servant is sick. Come and heal my servant. And Jesus said, I'm coming. On the way, the man said to Jesus, don't come. I'm not worthy that you come under my roof. Amen.
Amen.
I am not worthy that you come under my roof. And I also am a man under authority. I've got servants under me. If I say to the servant, go, they go. If I say to them, come, they what?
They come.
Don't come. Speak the words, and my servant will be healed. Look at this man. Speak only the what?
The
word. Jesus never met such people. You know, people need contact. This generation needs contact. If you don't give them something, they won't believe. They need conduct. They need tangible stuff. If you just give them the word, they will not believe. They need conduct. But that means is, don't come. Speak a word only, and my servant will be what?
Will
be healed. And Jesus said, she stopped and he said, people, I've never seen such great faith. No, not in Israel. I've never seen such great faith. Look at what is called great faith. Great faith is when a person believes the word. Just the word, and the person takes the word to be God. The moment you take the word to be God, that's like faith. Which other God do you want to speak? If you cannot obey this certain word, which other God do you want to speak? He's the one speaking. He's the one speaking. Is the one speaking. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's the one speaking.